with the exclusive SA Artist Spotlight performance of his single, Go Back Again, the incredibly talented Glen Hodgson's Lost and Found. Hey music fans, and welcome to another exciting show of the SA Artist Spotlight. Now, you would be forgiven for thinking that this gentleman with me is none other than bass guitar superstar Glen Hodgson from the Parlotones, and you would be absolutely bloody correct. But we're not here to talk Parlotones today. We are here to discuss an exciting new adventure in Glen's musical journey, none other than his debut solo project, Lost and Found. Yep. Glen, thank you so much for taking some time to join us, brother.
Cool, good to be here.
So listen, Lost and Found, let's start with a name. Obviously, a lot of band names, you can quite clearly hear that they're just a name for the sake of being a name. But Lost and Found kind of feels like there's some reference there, or some deeper meaning. You know? Well, what's that all about?
Yeah, I think it's just you find yourself, like for me, like the EP is a bit of a journey, like starting kind of at rock bottom where your life's just a mess and ending with a bit of hope. So it's kind of just like the, you know, like the Amazing Grace song, Lost and Found. Kind of being lost and finally finding yourself on the right path. Not essentially like perfectly happy, but going in the right direction.
But a journey moving in the right direction.
That's
it. And has that exactly what this has been for you? I mean, can you feel yourself both emotionally as a person and as an artist moving in the right direction?
Yeah, it's been quite an experience because I've had these songs kind of on the shelf, bottled up inside me for so long. So it's been quite a release to finally just get them out. It's almost like a therapy session.
I was about to say, it must be kind of a cathartic process getting all these words finally being able to release them to other people's ears as well.
Yeah, and I mean just for myself, just to finally address them, get them down and get them out.
Now clearly, obviously listening to you perform, you don't become a songwriter overnight. So this is something that you mentioned that you've been working on for some time. I guess the most logical question is to kind of ask, well, why have you decided to release that now? What's so right about now in this time to actually kind of step out and say, okay, let's do this? Because I'm sure you've probably thought about it a million times already.
Yeah, I mean, the songs have been there for years. We just never really had time. With the Parlotones being so busy, always on the road, like always doing that. And then sort of towards the beginning of last year, we found ourselves with some time. Like we took a bit of a break.
It's like, what can I do?
Yeah, Khan went and did his solo thing, so I thought, well, what better time than now to do the same? So I just did it.
just like that?
Just recorded them and started performing.
Was there any kind of apprehension or nerves? I mean, listen, we know two things about bass guitarists. Point number one, the coolest fucking people in the band by far, far none. Number two, they're quite happy to step under the spotlight, jam a few bass riffs, and then retire back to the safety of the wings of the stage and kind of back into the shadows.
Yeah.
Obviously, embarking on a solo project like this, you're kind of thrusting yourself right under into the spotlight, or into the limelight, to say. Was there a kind of level of exposure or apprehension to kind of how people would respond?
I never realized how terrifying it would be. Like you said, you get so used to being not the center of attention, just the guy on the side, you know? And you leave that job to the lead singer. And when I finally took the step and put myself on stage, just me and my guitar in front of people, I was the most scared I've ever been in years. So, like, it took a while to finally get used to it.
So it must be a different kind of nerve set than getting on. I mean, if you can remember the first gig you ever played with the Parlotones, I mean, that's going back years and years and years now. But if you can compare that emotion to the first time stepping out at Lost and Found doing a solo performance, can you remember how you felt?
I think with Parlotones it was more excitement. With Lost and Found it was more sheer terror and trying to keep my knees from breaking each other. And still get super nervous before I play, because it's a different thing. You're kind of exposing yourself to the audience and like seeing how good you actually are, if you can do this or not.
Well, that's another thing I was going to ask. I mean, how do you measure whether this for you is, or how do you measure this process? Is it going to be on the response of the audience, or is it for you just something that you're dealing with as a personal journey? And if you get up there and do it to the best of your ability, then that's it, that's great.
Yeah, I think it's a bit of both. You know, you just get up there and play as best you can, and then hope that when you get off stage, someone's going to say something good about it. And like, as you go along, like I can feel my voice getting stronger and kind of be on my stage presence getting stronger, and more people will come up to me and say, wow, I've seen such a change in you, like compliment me. So it's a bit of everything that kind of helps you keep on going.
Now, obviously, I guess, like you said, you're learning a whole new stagecraft, really, aren't you? I mean, compared to standing, jamming bass for the Parlotones and now being a front man, a vocalist, acoustic guitar, obviously it highlights your musical ability and your variety. But I guess you are going to have to learn different kind of interaction with the audience and a whole different new set of skills.
Yeah, it's like being dropped at the bottom of the barrel again, because like the shows I'm playing aren't Parlotone kind of shows. They're just like Sunday mornings at a farmer's market, you know, playing to people who's no one's actually listening to you, or like a bar, you know, to like 10 people first on the ball. So it's kind of cool. It's kind of like that sort of punk rock thing again, where no one actually knows that you're in this other band.
Yeah.
You're just some guy first on the ball. plain. So in that way, there's no sort of expectations of like, oh, look who's on stage. It's Glen from the Parlotones. Like, no one ever really knows.
I've just gone back to Glen from Lost and Found.
Yeah, now it's just this dude on stage playing acoustic guitar. So it's a nice sort of training ground again.
Obviously, being a member of an incredibly successful group and successful band, music would have taken you to many countries, experienced many different things. How do those, with music being such a, obviously an important part of your life, how do those kind of highs and the lows of the music industry inspire your writing?
It's a good question.
I know, thank you. But I mean, people have this preconceived idea that a rock and roll star lives this glamorous life, all hotel rooms, champagne, caviar, nothing bad ever happens to you, you don't have to work a mundane 9-to-5 office job, some boss shouting at you every single day. But I can only imagine that just like any other kind of job, it comes with its bad days and its lows as well.
No, for sure.
That must definitely inspire you to some level with the kind of lyrics you write down. And
yeah, well, actually, we're talking about it now before this interview.
Yeah.
How your life is so weird because you'll be on tour for 6 weeks. You know, seeing all these countries, playing these shows, living this certain life, and then you get home and it's like normal life again. And it's kind of like a balancing act where you're not quite sure where you actually fit in anymore. You can't stay too long at home because you feel like you want to be on the road again.
Itchy feet again.
But then when you're on the road, all you want to do is come home. So it's kind of just like that emotional juggling, I guess, that brings the songs out of you.
Well, saying that then, do you think this solo project of yours in some way will bring some kind of balance back to your kind of, to your life? Or understand your place in this journey, where you are, or bring kind of some kind of stability to your musical journey?
I think it has in a way because, like, a lot of the songs that I wrote years ago on the road, you know, with the Parlotones, and I was in a certain way, certain space back then, dealing with certain demons, and I wrote that song, and then put it on the shelf, carried on touring, wrote another song. So when I recorded the EP, and you go back and you reflect on that journey, you kind of see where, what space you're in for every song, and you actually deal with stuff you haven't dealt with that you've just put on the shelf by writing or by recording the songs and performing them. Like I said, it's like a bit of a therapy session because you've never dealt with this, but you wrote about it at that time and now you're finally dealing with it and getting over it.
Is it difficult though to, obviously you say some of these songs were written some time ago, going through say some dark periods or some dark patches. And you're at a stage now where you're clearly quite happy with life and you're at a stage where you say you feel good about things. However, you are performing songs that will obviously dig up a lot of memories of those days that weren't so good. Isn't that weird?
No, I think it's a good thing because, like you said, I'm in a good place now, so I've dealt with that and I've kind of let it go. So when I do sing those songs, it's a good feeling because I know that I've dealt with it and I've let it go and now I can move on.
So would you say being able to do a musical project like this and dealing with those kind of issues from the past have brought you some kind of closure to those issues?
No, for sure. Yeah, a lot of wounds that have been open for many years have finally closed through this process. So. Been good.
Now, without kind of pigeonholing yourself at all, what kind of musical style do your songs and your lyrics tend to lean themselves towards from a performance point of view?
I'd say like Damien Rice, that direction, Frank Turner.
Ooh, bring out the classics.
Love Frank Turner. He was a huge influence on my songwriting. And Damien Rice's lyrics as well. They're to the point and like they cut to the bone. There's no metaphors or anything too obscure. It's just kind of, he says it how it is, like Frank Turner too.
Same, yeah.
And that's the direction I go in.
So would you say most of your music is very lyrically driven?
Yeah, no, definitely. Because I'm a jangler. You know, I can't play guitar too well, so I just stick to chords and hope that the words do the job.
Now, looking forward down the line, what does the future hold for Lost and Found? Have you set any kind of, I don't want to say expectations, but milestones or measurements that you would like to achieve with this project from a personal point of view?
Yeah, no, I haven't. From the start, I had no goal, no direction. I knew I just wanted to record those songs, and that's what I did, and then see where it went, and here I am now. So I'd like to record an album eventually. That's the only solid goal. Otherwise, jumping on tours like this one, playing around wherever.
Could we be closer to a Glen Hodgson show, just on your own, with that kind of piggybacking on the back of other shows?
Yeah, I'll have to eventually, I guess. Find a nice small 20-seater venue.
Start.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, that's the next terrifying step I have to take. I think I'm just kind of in the training zone right now still.
It's incredibly refreshing to see somebody who's been around so long, who's obviously so confident on stage and has been in the industry for so long, actually admitting just how daunting and terrifying it could be.
Mm.
Because people can only imagine how that is. You know, but people think, well, nah, he's been in the industry for ages. This must be a walk in the park for him. But clearly not.
No, yeah. When it's your own songs you perform, and it's a different story.
Okay, so you've got an EP out at the moment. For anyone out there who wants to have a listen, how can they get their hands on some of your stuff or some of your material?
It's on iTunes and Amazon and all those music sites. I got a website, glenhodgson.com.
Okay. We'll be providing details of that after the show as well, so definitely make sure you go check that out.
Yeah. Cool. And
that's about it.
We'll see where it goes from here.
Now, we're obviously just a couple hours away from watching Glen perform another show here this evening. We're incredibly excited. Glen, as I said, for someone who's been around for as long as you have, I just want to stress again, it's obviously not about luck, but just wishing you as much success as you possibly deserve in the future. And we look forward to seeing some more from Lost and Found and hearing a lot more about it. And just wish you a sincere amount of joy in this process. It's something that you thoroughly deserve. Like I said, you've not paid your dues with your years in the industry, but I guess if someone has been around for as long as you have, deserves the right to kind of follow their other musical dreams and passions, you definitely do. So thanks very much for taking some time out to chat to us.
Thank you very much.
And we look forward to hearing a lot more from you.
Cool.
Cool.
Thanks for having me.
Cheers, brother. Closing out the show tonight with his single new song, the incredibly talented Mr. Glen Hodgson.
I'm not the same, though I know got some distance left to run. Mountains, they crumble under my command. I'll turn you into stone, and then I'll rebuild your hard and fragile heart. I'll turn it into one that I can call my own. I'll part these oceans, I'll fill the space between, build a house right there that we can call our home. And in the distance, that form a shadow of myself will look back and smile, no longer left to roam. Sound of my new song. Can you tell? I know I've been doing this all wrong. Because the past is the past and what's done is done. And I'm so proud of this person I've become. A 100 days, I'm not the same though. I know I've got some distance left to run. Running right back home like the prodigal son.
Nothing is impossible.